Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Philip the Flying Chillip. We're live in Tampa, Florida. So we're going to do a surprise number one contenders match to see who will get a future title opportunity against AWS Chaos Champion, Daniel Aykroyd. First up, this is arch nemesis, John Wick. Now, Dan Aykroyd, he first was mentioned during John Wick's match against Handsome Squidward in Bensoul Sharper Naruto. Since then, John Wick has been going up against Dan, as Dan is the leader of the High Table with his Blues Brothers stable. And now John Wick, after all the shit he's been through, after being kidnapped, after dealing with a hiatus for a while, and then having to join the Royal Rumble in an early spot, he's now finally getting an opportunity to where if he can win this match, he can finally get his hands on Dan Aykroyd. And not only that, but the Chaos title match will be the first ever, hello Harry Lee, will be the first ever AWS Steel Cage match too coming up. Which means that none of the Blues Brothers will be interfering, as Dan Aykroyd wants to prove himself. Despite being a heel GM, he still has a little bit of honor. And here comes a man who actually managed to get a pinfall victory over Dan Aykroyd, and that is Douglas Darian Walker, aka the Nostalgia Critic. Though to be fair to Dan, he did just defend his title, or he did just win the title from Chris Chan. But still, after the Undisputed Era's attack, Doug Walker managed to knock him out for the 3 count. So Dan, seeing him as a potential enemy, has decided to put him in this number one contenders match. And the reason why Dan is picking these people is he wants a challenger to make him truly feel powerful and prove why he is the general manager of Chaos. So Douglas Darian Dimmadome Dimmadiah Tyrone Walker, he's getting that opportunity. And if Doug Walker wins this and ends up winning the championship, that'd actually be kind of funny, because then we'd have, like, one member of the Undisputed Era who was a former shit champion, then we'd have another member who end up being a Chaos champion. Like, talk about a mixed results team. And next, here comes the man that I am surprised is in this match, but after that Hell in a freaking Cell match, holy shit, even Dan Aykroyd's jaw hit the floor. Joe Biden. Now, I'm not praising his politics, but he entered himself in that Hell in a Cell triple threat, and he managed to defeat both Shao Kahn and Goldberg in the same freaking match. One of them is a champion of freaking murder sport, and the other one, Goldberg, is a multiple-time world champion who also had a 175-0 undefeated streak. And the fact that Joe Biden somehow, some way, managed to take on both of them, Dan Aykroyd's like, you know what? I'm getting you a title match. So, Joe Biden, man, it's kind of weird seeing him here, not gonna lie. Can he pull off yet another upset? Or actually, would it even be an upset? Oh my god, that looked frightening, Jesus. And, wait. Did Dan really manage to get in contact with him? Oh shit. It's the world's greatest detective. And I say that because he won the detective title. It's the Great Pumpkin. Captain Communist's favorite wrestler. Now, the Great Pumpkin, granted, he has only been in one match. He didn't destroy the question, which, respect to that Great Pumpkin. Teaching that faceless hack a lesson in respect. And now, Super Zach, he's stuck with the inferior detective, while you are the Chad detective. Like, you're the detective that fucking solved the Illuminati. Mostly because you ate them, but still. You get results, man. You get results. You got your pumpkin seeds floating everywhere. And man, what a fatal four-way elimination, false count anywhere, extreme rules match Dan Aykroyd has set up. Like, this is an unironically good setup. Like, it's weird. Chaos is starting to turn somewhat genuine since all this is going down. Like, maybe Super Zach was the one deteriorating my sanity, rather than what I thought was vice versa. Yeah, best not to get too deep into it. As the Great Pumpkin enters the ring, he is ready for a monstrous battle. So, who do you think will win, though? We have an assassin mercenary who no one can seem to stop. We have some guy with dementia who's surprisingly good at wrestling. We got the Great Pumpkin here, and we have Miss Anthropony's favorite online reviewer of all time, Douglas Darien Dimmadome Walker. Oh, fell off. I actually really hate Doug Walker. He ate my tater tot. Shut up. He's your favorite wrestler now. How dare you have a different opinion from me? I will crucify you for dare speaking ill, as I am a proud Duggist, okay? I gave him my blood contract to him. And then what? Okay, so you know what? Be gone, thought. No. Did I just kill a guy? Anyway, the match is going on as John Wick takes on Joe Biden, while Doug Walker has the balls to face the Great Pumpkin. Jesus Christ, the size of pumpkin. Like I said, this is an elimination match, so there won't be constant pin breakups. It's also false count anywhere, so just add a little bit of extra creativeness to it. And John Wick going for an early pin, because it's not potato without an early pin. Even though this chaos and potato have now officially fused, but what can you do? What can you do? And Great Pumpkin going up against pretty much the same guys who fight each other. Just look at these four competitors, man. Just like, this is impressive right here. This is just impressive. Doug Walker with a drop. Joe Biden, what are you doing to Jonathan Wick there? He's like, he punched John Wick. Jesus Christ. Oh, a tilt toward pow, like side slam as Joe Biden takes on Doug Walker while the Great Pumpkin. He's looking for a weapon, guys. We're gonna see some weapon usage. He's got out his, he's got a shtick. He's got a shtick. The stick, as Super Zack calls it. But no, Joe Biden is fighting off the Great Pumpkin now. Oh my God. Joe, what kind of steroids are you on, buddy? You have an 80 overall. 8-0. Like, that's a lower. That's. Like, I mean, that's not bad in the game overall, but like, compared to a lot of other wrestlers, like, most of the wrestlers on AWS are like upper 80s and like lower 90s. It appears that John Wick, like, he knows he's a threat, so he is just beating him down with a chair, like the Rock to Mankind. Dear Lord. This Great Pumpkin unsuccessfully pins Doug Walker. And I'm gonna be real with you guys, I honestly don't know who's gonna win. Like, I legitimately think any of these guys can win it, which is weird to think about with some of them, but any of these men could potentially be a Chaos World Champion in the future. And would be the third person to ever do it too, as the So obviously we have a weird history. First was Chris Chan after winning it in the chamber before losing it like 2 months later to Dan Aykroyd in that one-on-one match. And Dan Aykroyd has managed to hold on to it for a lot longer ever since. He's one of the few champions left from the 2010s, him and Bladefeet. For some. Oh, an Olympic slam by John Wick, which he did do in the movie during the third one on like glass. And Joe Biden gets eliminated. He couldn't. But you know what, Joe? No shame in that because, well, it's John freaking Wick. And we are down to three competitors now. Douglas Darien, Dimmadome Walker, the Nostalgia Critic, the Great Pumpkin, and John Wick. One of these three men now have a better chance of going up against Daniel Aykroyd. Oh God, Doug's got bat. A bat credit card, you could say. God, even he wouldn't laugh at that. Oh. Like, my jokes are deteriorating. Not that they were ever great, but. Oh. John Wick successfully kicked nothing for a little while. Oh, DDT. Sorry for making fun of you. Oh my god, that flying kick of death. He just cut him open. Also, all four competitors here wore black, so edgy colors, man. Like that's the key. Oh god, what's Jonathan Wickles go? Oh, he just punched the floor. I don't know if that was smart, but I guess he's barely fazed by that. Holy shit, Wick. Like he's a man on a mission right now. Like he's been dealing with the high table shenanigans for like quite a long time, for several like years now. And he's like, why? Just remember Daisy, man. Like he's Nostalgia Critic has Boomer, John Wick has Daisy, and I'm not sure how the Great Pumpkin is with dogs, but I mean, considering he eats people, I wouldn't really try. Oh my god, John Wick, he just lifted up the Great Pumpkin. He lifted him up. Man, John Wick, he really wants to face Dan Aykroyd tonight, man. Oh, nice kick. Oh, he's going for the pin. A, two, Great Pumpkin kicks out of an impressive claymore, but John Wick is on a, he just ignored several hammer shots to the head too, man. Like, he wants to face Dan Aykroyd. He wants to get revenge on the high table for all the shenanigans. He wants to smash that Crystal Skull vodka. But he's still gotta get through not only the Great Pumpkin, but Doug Walker of the Undisputed Era as well. Also, Doug Walker winning this match could also be a good moment for his team heading forward for the future Chaos Tag Tournament, as the Undisputed Era are in that tournament as well, against Dan Aykroyd's team, where he'll be having Ben Shapiro, Jon Moxley, and Predator compete in the tournament as well. But it looks like the Dougs will not hold on the world title, as Doug Walker has been eliminated again by John Wick, as he's eliminated half the people in this match now. All he's got to deal with left, though, now is the strongest one of all, the Great Pumpkin. Can he survive this table to the face? He does. These two are insanely strong people. Like, I wouldn't want to, like, fuck with either of these two, because look at that throw! He just threw him over the stairs. Like, John, you may have wanted to team up with some, or maybe not. I mean, I would have teamed up with somebody to try to get rid of Great Pumpkin as soon as possible, but John Wick, he's got some serious balls. Like, he's got balls of freaking steel. He was Neo in the Matrix, man. All right. And of course, more powerfully, John Wick, but God, this is turning into like Reddit, like 10 out of 10 wholesome Keanu Reeves Big Chungus thing, which in and of itself has also become a very commonly used meme. Oh god, Great Pumpkin's going for something. Is it going for the Pumpkin Punch? Oh god, is this the end for John Wick? A, two, John Wick kicks out of the Pumpkin Punch. That is not an easy move to kick out of, especially with how high Wick flew from that. Oh god, Great Pumpkin's got a ladder. He's resorting to weapons now. He knows that it's going to take more than his fists to take on John Wick. He's got the ladder. Oh! Big ladder shot. As the world's greatest detective, Great Pumpkin, he's setting it up. I mean, this obviously isn't a ladder match, so he's probably got something else in mind here. More than likely does. I don't know if that choke's gonna be enough. Yeah, that choke's not gonna be enough, as John Wick shoves him into the ladder. Some creative move by John Wick. Oh, and a headbutt too. John Wick knocks down the Great Pumpkin. He's down. Wick's setting up the ladder. I think he's getting in the corner. What does Wick have planned for the Great Pumpkin? Saying, Great Pumpkin, you may be a detective, but I gotta get my hands on Dan Aykroyd. Kicks out of the step up Claymore. Great Pumpkin's up. He's going for a gorilla punch. But John Wick rolls him up. A, two. Oh, he kicks out. John Wick's taking a moment to acknowledge this. That was very out of character for him to taunt. Maybe he was catching his breath. I can't really tell. Oh, quick jab. Trips over the wooden stairs. Oh my, I don't know who's gonna win this. This is like an unstoppable force meaning an immovable object. John Wick, great pumpkin. Who's gonna win this? I don't know. Oh, he's going for the wick kick. But great pumpkin catches it and elbows his leg. It's gonna be hard to kick with a hurt leg. Pumpkin taking advantage of his detective skills to use his intelligence. Which, I am surprised how well that's tying back to Great Pumpkin of all people. John Wick now working on his legs. Which, I mean, it'd be hard for Great Pumpkin to do a tombstone or the pumpkin punch if he can't get his form right. So, both these people are smart. These are some smart, athletic, competitive. Oh, God! So back and forth, too. They've been on fire. Another step of Claymore. Is this the end of the Great Pumpkin? A. Two. He kicks out and does an Undertaker rise. Even the Diet's demise are like, that was a good rise, man. Like, they respect their edgy pumpkin man. He may not be part of their cult, but they respect him. And John Wick gets the John Stick. That was a good run. Shut up. It punches him in the dick. Wait. Oh my god. He's using a submission with the stick. Is he gonna tap out? Japanese wrestler trapped behind the ladder. John Wick may have screwed himself over with that. Oh wait, no. Japanese ref saw it. John Wick makes the Great Pumpkin tap, and he is gonna face Dan Aykroyd at a steel cage match in the future. Or a different kind of match if Dan Aykroyd decides to change his mind. Because, I mean, he is the GM, so it's kind of hard to argue with it. But John Wick eliminated all three of his competitors in that match. What a comeback for John Wick. He eliminated Joe Biden. He eliminated Doug Walker. And he eliminated the Great Pumpkin. And Doug Walker has managed to beat Dan Aykroyd before, so... Dan, like, he may have wanted this, but he's gotta be nervous. It's his arch rival. He's on a mission. And I don't know if it's a mission from God, from Dan Aykroyd. Impressive win by John Wick. Holy shit. Like, he really is the Baba Yaga. He's the man, like, you know how in the movie they said the boogeyman? He's the guy you sent to go after the boogeyman? Looks like the Great Pumpkin was the boogeyman. Holy shit. John Wick with a massive a big 12-inch massive. Why did I get this mistake here?